Now let's consider how to handle a surface integral. A surface is shown here, and let's suppose that it has a charge distribution. Let's say it has 4 coulombs per meter squared, and I want to know how much total charge is on this plate. The way you could tell manually, the way you'd be used to doing this, is you would take the charge density and you'd multiply it by the area of the plate, which we can see is 2 by 3 meters. So you take 4 coulombs per meter squared, you'd multiply it by 6, and you get 24 coulombs would be on this plate. Now let's see how to do it with a surface integral. When I have a simple surface like this, I need to decide which of my surface integral terms to use. I can do that two ways. The simplest way for me is to look at what changes. So this plate has a choice of dx, dy, or dz changing. With any plate, two of these three things are going to change. On this plate, does dx change? No, dx is always zero, x is always zero, so dx, the change in x, is always zero. Does y change? Yes, indeed it does. Dy is not zero. Does z change? Yes, it changes also, so dz is zero. So let's look right here at the d terms. This is dy dz, that's the change term I defined. Here dx is 0, and here dx is 0. So I can see that I have an x-directed plate, and I'm going to integrate by dy dz. Now how else could I have done this? The other thing that I might have done is used my right-hand rule to do an external surface with my fingers, make my fingers go around in this direction, in the counterclockwise direction, and then my thumb would have pointed in the x direction. That's the other way I could have told what the plate was. So let's do our surface integral. The surface integral is going to be a double integral. Put our function, 4 coulombs per meter squared here, and dy dz. Y is going to vary from 1 to 4, and z is going to vary from 1 to 3. When I do my integration, I'm going to have 4 coulombs per meter squared, y from 1 to 4, z from 1 to 3, which is going to give me 4 times 3 times 2. And that's going to give me the 24 coulombs that I had before, agreeing with my previous result. Now what would have happened? Let's just do a little change here. What would have happened? Instead of being uniform, I'm going to make a non-uniform value. So instead of being 4 coulombs per meter squared, let's say that this increases with y. So the small value of my current is over here, the larger value of current is on this end. So if I had 4y here instead of 4, when I did my integration in y, I would have ended up with y squared over 2. This would have ended up with 3 squared over 2, and then I would have ended up with a different number right here. So one of the important things with doing our line, surface, and volume integrals is to remember they're not separable functions, which means in this case, I cannot remove this value outside of the integral. I actually need to integrate it right in here, as you can see. So let's just briefly summarize the steps that I did when I chose my surface integral. The first step was that I defined what changes. So either dx, dy, or dz changes. Since dx was 0, I set all of my other dx terms also equal to 0, and that was able to tell me what it was that I needed to integrate. So the first thing was to define what it was that was changing in my system so that I could define the ds term that I needed to use. You'll notice that I did not use the vector form because I was integrating a scalar equation. Then I set up my integral, so the third thing was set up my integral using the dy dz term that I defined in step number 2 above, plug in my function, whether it's uniform or not, and then do the integral, simply work out the value.